How's it going? My name is Amy, and I work at Lowe's. Stop by today and beat the heat with some cool summer savings. Now get 10% off major appliances priced $397 or more. And with our great selection, you'll find just what you're looking for. Choose from top brands like Whirlpool, Samsung, Frigidaire, and Maytag. Or if you need carpet, now you can get free basic installation when you purchase Stainmaster carpet and Stainmaster carpet pads. Come chill out with our coolest savings yet. Lowe's. Let's build something together. Offers valid through 8/29. Some restrictions apply. See store for details.
The Stoner Jesus Show is brought to you by WestCoastMasters.com and THCFinder.com. If you're a marijuana grower and you're only getting ounces per plant, that's because you don't know the secrets of the West Coast Masters and you need the book. You go to WestCoastMasters.com, you can get the book, The Secrets of the West Coast Masters. They will tell you how to yield more than a pound per plant indoors. That's right, more than a pound of fine quality, high grade medical marijuana indoors, but you need the book. And to get it, you got to go to WestCoastMasters.com. If you're not a grower, but you're a patient in a medical marijuana state, then you need to go to THCFinder.com. You can find the closest dispensary near you. You can talk to other people in the forums about strains and the dispensaries. You can see reviews of that dispensaries from medical marijuana patients just like yourself. Not only that, there's like I said, there's the forum, there's news, a blog, contests, all kinds of cool shit. Go to THCFinder.com if you're a medical marijuana patient and you want to find the closest dispensary near you. WestCoastMasters.com and THCFinder.com, two proud sponsors of the Stoner Jesus Show. Also, if you want to hear the Stoner Jesus Show, you can Thursday nights at 10 p.m. on GasHouseRadio.com. And of course, you can hear all the podcasts at StonerJesus.net. If you would like to be a sponsor of the Stoner Jesus Show, email us at StonerJesus420@gmail.com. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, the Stoner Jesus Show.
And I'm thinking, gotta get high. Got my bitch breaking down the gram on the high times. Higher than the eagle, not like ordinary people. We hotbox the pad so much that we fogged up the peephole. Blowing smoke from the rooftop.
Hell yeah. Welcome, everyone. I do believe that we are live on GasHouseRadio.com. It's a little after 10 p.m. here in the East. We're in the Stoner Jesus Studios. As I said, broadcasting live on GasHouse.com. GasHouseRadio.com. They're based in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, for those of you who do not know. We are in the mid-Ohio River Valley, where we broadcast from the Stoner Jesus Studios. I am here in the studio, of course, with my sidekick, St. Peter. What up, Peter?
What up, Bill?
Word. In honor of Philly, we have an all-Philly show tonight. All the things we like and all the things we don't like about Philadelphia. And as a special treat, St. Peter is going to rap along with the Fresh Prince of Bel Air song. So that's going to be awesome.
Check it out, dude.
I'm going to check the chat room at Gas House Radio. We got some people in there. Let's see. Cannabis Clay says the show's pretty quiet compared to the other show. Sorry, I just blazed a super sativa. Well, first of all, good for you. Second of all, I don't know. You know, me and Dustin, the guy who runs Gas House Radio, we've been going back and forth about the audio quality. I was going to try to go with their software tonight, but I decided, I made an executive decision to go with Blog Talk Radio as a base and simulcast on gashouseradio.com. One, because so far, knock on wood, I mean, you can use your head, Peter. Thank you. So far, we've had no problems with Blog Talk Radio. I was testing out their software, which, for all intents and purposes, is a more advanced version of what Blog Talk Radio can do. There's it's more automated. You can line things up to play. And with Blog Talk Radio, basically, I play whatever I decide when I decide to do it. I was also on Spreaker.com. Did some live shows there. You can check those out at standardjesus.net. Podcasts 18 through 23, 24, I don't know. I don't remember anymore. It's been so fucking long. Actually, it's been that long, but... What, Peter?
Let's get this shit going, dude. I feel like nothing's going on.
You know, first of all, and people... There's this one dude on Twitter that complained to me about the quality of your voice and the fact that you really can't understand what you're saying. He says you... He's like, first of all, this dickhead, he had like 90 followers, and he's preaching to me about how to get fucking listeners for my radio show. Each fucking show I do, between live show and podcast, boy, that was, my accent really came out there. People always tell me I have an accent because I'm, because we're in Kentucky, but I don't hear it, of course. But, people in the chat room are saying that the show sounds better now. I'm going to pull down the chat room and check the phone call. If you want to call live, 760-454-1109. That's one of the reasons we were sticking with Blog Talk Radio tonight, the simulcast on Gas House Radio, but there's no chat room on Blog Talk Radio. Fuck that. You want to hear us? You come to gashouseradio.com on Thursday nights, and you hear what's going on. I'm rambling. I'm skipping subjects. I understand that. Getting back to my original point, the audio quality, it is what it is. Blog Talk Radio has its limitations, and one of its limitations is you cannot pay them extra money to get better quality. There's no such thing as quote-unquote CD quality audio with Blog Talk Radio. I'm not sure why that is. I mean, they got to make enough money. I mean, come on. It's not that fucking hard to broadcast. I understand if you're going through the phone, but I'm going through Skype. That's just your better audio. Anyway, I'm not going to bitch about that all night. So far, so good. As I said, we're going to talk about Philadelphia all night because Gas House Radio is based in Philly. And I have to say... We did internet radio a long time ago on RadioDiscon.com, which doesn't exist anymore. Some dude who was a cab driver in Colorado, he had an internet radio station, and one of his show was like, he would tape people in his cab. He would like record the conversations and play them for his show. Anyway, my show, I did like the Stern Jesus show, and Peter, you weren't with me then, were you? Yeah. Anyway, I was also talking about the quality of St. Peter's voice. Look, man, first of all, it's the fucking point. If you listen to the show, the point is you can't understand what he's saying. He has throat cancer, man. He's got a big, ugly black box with, like, electrical wires sticking out of it in his fucking neck. What am I going to do about that? Miracle his ass? A new voice box? Fuck that. Fuck you, Peter. You don't get a new voice box. I can make you one like that. If you heard that, I snapped my fingers. This is a radio show. Let me snap my fingers. Doesn't mean anything to anybody. let's go check the chat room. Make sure there's nothing. Lord Weedus says, why don't you Ustream, SJ? Actually, if you go to standardjesus.net, we did Ustream shows, but all I did is I put up like the picture of Standard Jesus. I don't fucking want to be taped doing my show. It's radio. It's radio for a point. I don't want to do TV. First of all, I'm not very photogenic. And with TV, you got to have cool graphics and all that shit. There's cool shit on TV. You don't need to see me. Radio is where it's at. Radio is a much more imaginative medium. A lot of the bits we do, if you go back and listen to the shows, that shit wouldn't fly on Ustream. Are you kidding me? But that's not the point. We got kicked off of Ustream just for showing, if you're on GasHouseRadio.com right now, and you're, well, you are, if you're hearing me, because you're not listening on Blog Talk Radio, that'd be stupid. There's no fucking chat room there. You want to be at GasHouseRadio.com. You see the picture of Stoner Jesus, that's what we had. Angie Hempelseed on Facebook drew that picture 5 years ago of Stoner Jesus holding a roar bong and a joint. And that got us banned from Ustream. That and I guess talking about weed. Because we tend to talk about weed a little bit on this show. If you're just a first-time listener and you never heard us, we do discuss the weedage. The weedage. Anyway, don't fucking worry about St. Peter's audio quality is my first point. Second of all, like I told Dustin earlier tonight, as long as people can hear me, they can hear the words I'm saying, and the funny, witty shit that's coming out of my mouth, then we're good to go. GTG. there was something else. Canvas Clay said, what's St. Peter digesting tonight? You doing anything special tonight, Peter?
Drinking a little bit.
Yes, he's drinking a little bit. Good for you, Peter. way to be a part of the show, dickweed. I am I'm drinking also. What the fuck is this shit? I raid the lockers and the cabinets and of all the interns and shit of the Stoner Jesus Studios to find shit, and I found this Sex on the Beach ready to drink shots. It's 40 proof, 20% alcohol, so I've been banging back this for a while. That's pretty good. Makes for more interesting radio. And another reason that we didn't go with the more complicated software tonight, because I can't handle any technical difficulties right now. If Blog Talk Radio kicks me off the air, I will get back on the air, and I will bitch and moan like a motherfucker. Excuse me. But as I said, we have all filled up the shit going tonight. We have 2 hours. We're going to midnight Eastern time. We are live. Let's see. On Twitter, you can find me at StonerJesus420. If you have an MP3, if you're a band, a rapper, a comedian, send me an MP3. We're going to play some songs tonight people sent me, as we do every show. Send to StonerJesus420@gmail.com. And if you want to leave a voicemail, if you can't get a hold of us while we're live, and I don't really see why you can't. I mean, there's a few people on the phone, but none of them have clicked over to listen, or not to listen, to talk on the show. They're just listening on the phone. That's another cool thing about Blog Talk Radio that I like. You can listen on any phone. Now, you don't have to have an app or anything, although there is a Gas House Radio app if you want to go to the Android and iTunes little app markets there. Yeah, voicemail number 968, let's hold on, 888-968-9930. Probably started drinking a little too early. Oh, well. As I said, it makes for more interesting radio. We're going to go over the things we like about Philadelphia and the things we don't like about Philadelphia. As I said, St. Peter is going to sing along with the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air song. He's going to rap along with it a little bit later. We have all kinds of shit. We are also, in probably the second hour of the show, we're going to do live prank calls, as we like to do every once in a while. But we're going to have a special Philadelphia edition. First of all, Cannabis Clay, who was in the chat room, told me about Danny Bonaducci apparently is a Philadelphia radio host, and we were talking about Radio Wars a week and a half ago, whatever the fuck it was. Danny Bonaducci would be a cool guy to have a radio war with. I mean, I guess he has a name. But I also found a list of all the Philadelphia radio stations, and we're going to call them and see if we can get a hold of anybody and talk to them and tell them that we're coming for them. We're in Philadelphia now, and it's on. It's on like motherfucking Donkey Kong, as the kids say. MTPG has joined the chat room. What else we got in there? Bongmaster, Cannabis Clay, Dustin, of course, is in there. Lord Weedus, Road to Never, and some cool cat named Stoner Jesus, and a couple guests. Dustin said he's dead after Labor Day. I think Cannabis Clay said that he might have been canceled, and that's fucked up. He did give me the numbers for the station that he was on. And there's some guy on now doing a live radio. That's the thing about radio. There's usually somebody there. Some bored-ass disc jockey who's going to answer your call. So we'll call, and we'll tell them to keep Danny Bonaducci for the sole purpose of having a radio war with the Stoner Jesus Show. One of the things we like about Philadelphia, I'll knock off the first one here now before we go into music and shit. The first thing I like about Philadelphia is I'm a huge Howard Stern fan. If you don't know Howard Stern, the history of Howard Stern, which I know way, way too much about it. But the first city he was syndicated in after going to K-Rock in New York City and destroying Don Imus's stupid ass. He went to Philadelphia and YSP, I do believe, and he crushed John DiBella. It took him like a year and a half, and he totally fucked with this dude. He called his wife on the air and talked about their sex life. It was really awesome. And in the spirit of Radio Wars and the spirit of being in Philadelphia now, although I know people say, oh, well, you're on internet, you really, everybody can hear you everywhere. But guesthouseradio.com is a Philadelphia internet radio station. So we are going to call those people, call radio stations. We're going to call the Danny Bonaducci station and tell them that they need to keep him for, you know, the purposes of battling us in radio. And he, and if he would get on the air and really, really bitch about Stoner Jesus, that would be cool. And if he would throw in copious mentions of stonerjesus.net, that would be even cooler. Anyway, Lord Weedus said, Danny actually might come find you. He's fucking crazy. Yeah. Danny Bonaducci, for one, is a pretty big dude. And he'll probably kick the shit out of me. And I know you kick the shit out of St. Peter. You don't have my back, do you, fucker?
Not at all, dude.
Yeah, fuck you. I will tell him that it was all your idea. But he's not going to find me, first of all, because I'm in the Mid-Ohio Valley. I'm near Cincinnati, but come on. How's he going to find me? Well, who's going to find where I'm at, man? I'm in an undisclosed location as far as that goes. But anyway, that would be even cooler. If I could get that on video, because, man, Danny Bonaducci just had a hard fucking life. I mean, I don't know what kind of shape he's in. He looks pretty buff, but I don't know what his lung function is after all the drugs and shit he's done in his life. But I'm pretty sure I could outrun him while filming for video for our YouTube channel. That would be awesome. Danny Bonaducci chasing me down the street. Oh, fuck you, Stoner Jesus. He's like all in like roid rage and shit. That would be pretty cool. Anyway, I've spent enough fucking time telling you what's coming up. Let's just fucking do it. As I said, and hold on, man. I got to get this ready. No, that's not it. We got to go down here. I just saw it. Okay, now we're ready. No, we're not ready. I didn't find it. There it is. This is so professional. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Philadelphia night on the Stoner Jesus Show, debuting ourselves live on GasHouseRadio.com. Welcome to Philadelphia night. Yeah, that's the shit I'm talking about. Get pumped up. Oh, fuck, man. Anyway, like I said, this is Philly Night on Gas House Radio. Let's do one more check of the chat room before we go to some music and a break and whatnot so I can continue my inebriation goal for the night. Lord Weedus, Ballmaster, Canvas Clay, Rodenever, Smokey, who's that? Smokey Treats has now entered the chat room. Does Pennsylvania have lax MJ laws or medicinal MJ laws? I know Maryland is knocking on legalization. I will talk about that later. There has been some news, there's some marijuana news in Philadelphia, and I will get to that later in the show as we do, as we talk about the things we like about Philadelphia. One of the things we like about Philadelphia, just a little preview, is their betterment, at least, of the marijuana laws within the city of Philadelphia. As I said, we will do all that coming up. This is the Stoner Jesus Show live. We're on gashouseradio.com. Go Twitter and Facebook and Google all your bitches and tell them that we're on. I was sent a song earlier tonight from Cannabis Clay, who's in the chat room and is also happens to be a writer and contributor for the Stoner Jesus Show. Don't worry, Cannabis Clay. I will get to your Twitter questions after we get back from the break. But he sent me a song from someone named Meridian Smith, if I can find it. It would be awesome. This is one of the cool things about the software that I was going to use for Gas House Radio is, well, it was I could put shit in order and have it ready to go, and I wouldn't have to find anything. But you know, it is what it is. There's trade-offs, and I made a decision to go with this. And as long as people can hear me and kind of hear the songs, that's awesome. This is Center of Jesus Show Live. We are broadcasting simultaneously from Blog Talk Radio and in the chat room at gashouseradio.com. And we'll be podcasted, as always, at stonerjesus.net. If you're keeping track of home, this is show number 42 for stonerjesus.net. We'll be back right after this. Podcast on stonerjesus.net.
Fuck yeah, smoke pot, kids! Do your homework too, but when you're done, smoke pot and listen to music. Use headphones if you got them. Make sure to keep a pen and pad by your bed to write down all your thoughts. You might surprise yourself. And don't be lazy and just repeat them over and over in your head. Write them down! You'll forget that shit in the morning, it'll piss you right off. Oh, also, you should get a summer job. Mow lawn, something outside. If for no other reason than to get your parents off your back, am I right? Okay, get out of here, you rascals. Go find some pot.
Breaking down.
Hells yeah. Welcome back, everyone. The Stoner Jesus Show live. This is the Philadelphia show. We are celebrating our live debut on GuestHouseRadio.com, which is the Philadelphia internet radio station. We're going to get into here in a minute some of the more things we like about Philadelphia. First of all, I got to shout out this dude, Puff Squared. And that's the word squared, and it's all one word, Puff Squared, on Twitter. He sent me these things called Puff 2 or Puff Squared because secondhand smoke is killer. He sent me these things. Basically, it's a balloon, and you smoke your weed. You inhale your weed, and then you exhale into this balloon. And I guess you can exhale as much as you want and fill this balloon up. And then you have a balloon full of weed smoke that you can then smoke again. And he sent me a direct message on Twitter earlier today or yesterday or whatever the hell it was. And I told him that I would shout it out tonight on the show. Takes a little getting used to blowing, exhaling into a balloon. Takes a little more force. So you really have to force the weed, or the smoke anyway, into the balloon. But it works. I mean, you inhale it again and you blow out smoke. So Puff Squared on Twitter. It's all one word, Puff Squared. It's pretty awesome. Speaking of Twitter, let's go see what people are tweeting. Lord Weedus tweeted this out. Rasta, Jess Cash, one of the regulars in our chat room, is not in the chat room tonight for Gas House. Hopefully she is listening. I think that's her number, listening on the phone. She said, computer crash, and I'm 100% sober. Take a shot for me. Praise weed. Give a shout out. A shout to everyone to smoke for me. So if you're smoking and drinking, man, drink and smoke for Rasta X Sika on Twitter. Rasta X Sika. That's all one word. Let's see. See, Andrew, let's see. Alex Rocks RVA retweeted. Andrew WK said, party tip, party like Jesus, just gave you a high five. Okay. I get it. High five. Yes, there's Rasta says she's listening onto the phone. On the phone. Can't miss this awesome shit. I miss you, Dick Nuggets, in chat. We miss you too, Rasta. Guest House Radio tweeted us out. It's awesome. Blazing Canadian said, please, RT, trying to get my stuff out there. Thanks. It's a YouTube video. Well, let's see what their stuff is. Smoking Song Free Write on YouTube.
I got a weed song for you guys.
Hmm. It's Blazing Canadian on Twitter.
How about
this? They sent us something on Twitter, man. That's how easy it is to get on the show. Excuse me. Sorry. Continue.
I'm on that Jamaican baker, that doja, hold up. Let me roll up, break the swish in the middle, then I fold up. Hit that shit like the blunt about to get stole up. Green on me like an army soldier, hot box like it's cobra. Grind a bird like a can of Folgers, the moment I'm in so gorgeous. I sold you, this weed I sold you, it's quality shit. Like Gobra, get high baked like a pot, then hungry for a shake and fries. Think I take right at the night, think then I fly, late till I die. Think the guy we claim is the thief inside the store. Never wrap it in the floor, jar it up so it will not.
Okay, so anyway, it was I played some of it. I'm not gonna play the whole thing, we got a lot of shit to do. But Blazing Canadian, thank you for tweeting. That's Blazing _ Canadian. And now there's no G in Blazing. Blazing. It's Blazing _ Canadian. You follow him on Twitter. I got an let's see. Oh, Rasta got a tweet from Lord Weedus. Bongmaster on Twitter. I'm assuming that's Bongmaster in the chat. Let me go add you to one of my Twitter lists. I have two stoner Twitter lists now. I have almost 1,000 people in these lists. Bongmaster, you are in the list. He said, is jokes as fuck. I'm assuming that is a the younger generation's way of saying I'm fucking awesome. And I got to say, I got to agree. I'm pretty fucking awesome. St. Peter, on the other hand, is kind of a dickhead.
Fuck you, dude. You stupid bitch. I'll kick your ass.
You're not going to kick anybody's ass. I'm going to get Danny Viaducci back on the air. I'm going to have him kick your ass. Cannabis Clay sent me some Twitter questions earlier tonight. Let's see. Does SJ or Peter have a guilty pleasure movie? Does he secretly love beaches or The Notebook? Actually, St. Peter does have a guilty pleasure movie. And which one is that?
It's the Paris Hilton sex tape.
The Paris Hilton sex tape?
Yeah, man. She could really blow a dude in trailer.
I do know what you're saying. She could suck a golf ball through a garden hose. And many other Full Metal Jacket references, movie references, can be made here. You know, she could suck the chrome off a trailer hitch. Let's just lay it out there. Paris Hilton knows how to suck dick, all right? She's a stupid, vapid bitch who's good for nothing but sucking dick. But the one thing she is good at, she's really good at. Have you ever seen that sex tape? She knows how to slob the knob, as the kids say. They also say that. Movies, I love all kinds of movies. Nothing really guilty pleasure. My top five favorite movies of all time are The Godfather. Full Metal Jacket is my favorite. The Big Lebowski. Half-Baked, and, I know I'm forgetting something. I'm forgetting one of the fucking movies. I don't know. It'll come to me probably, and I will put it out there. Is there a movie that St. Peter and Stoner Jesus actually love watching together as buddies? Fuck no. I can barely stand being around St. Peter for this show. I'm not going to sit and watch a movie with him.
It's mutual, dude.
Yeah, I believe it is mutual, you stupid bastard. What kind of car does Stoner Jesus drive? Another question from Cannabis Clay on Twitter, writer and contributor for the show. Stoner Jesus does not drive, and St. Peter also does not drive, because if you go back to, I believe it's podcast number 33 on stonerjesus.net, and you will hear St. Peter's Covington Repo, you'll see that they took his car. And it's very sad. You can go check that out on podcast number 33. Okay. That's all the questions we got through on Twitter. Let me go check my direct messages. Let's see. Question from the message board. Phil Rostick, South Philly, wants to know, on your Philly cheesesteak, you like provolone or Cheese Whiz? I will be talking about Philly cheesesteaks here in our list of things we like about Philadelphia. But there's also the numbers for Danny Bonaducci's radio station in there. We will get to that. And thank you to Taylor_MTPG or MTPG in the chat room for tweeting us out as well. See, we've got an hour 24 left in this motherfucking episode. Let's see what's going on in the chat room. We're doing pretty good. Let's see. Smokey Treats put out state senator numbers blocking legislation to legalize in Pennsylvania. We may call them. Hell yeah. Why wouldn't we? We'll call anybody we want to. We do whatever the fuck we want. What else we got? Oh, yeah. We're going to talk about things we like about Philadelphia. We're also going to talk about Gas House Radio. For those of you who are fans of Stoner Jesus and really haven't checked out Gas House Radio, they have all kinds of cool shows on there. Every weekday at 5 p.m., Dustin and friends, Jim and others, they gather for the Brain Office. At Brain Office on Twitter, 5 to 7 every weekday, to talk about stuff and basically what I'm doing here, only not as Stoner Jesus-y, more Brain Office-y. They also have live shows on Tuesday and Friday night, and they do podcasts, but they also do, you go to GameSouthRadio.com, there's shows, the show list, although I'm not on the show list yet, I've noticed, Dustin, so there's the calendar. And archives, and just all kinds of stuff, and all the shows that are on GasHouseRadio.com, plus the music, 24 hours a day music, it's all good. You can get the app on iTunes and Android, the GasHouseRadio.com app. Let's see. Yeah. Canvas Clay said, I got to see that episode 33. Really, every podcast of the Stoner Jesus Show is a must-listen. Let's see. MedV is in the chat room now. You're welcome, Dustin. Like I was saying before about Radio Discon, it was some dude in a cab basically trying to do like pirate radio somewhere on the Rocky Mountains or what the fuck ever. GasHouseRadio.com is probably the most professional setup I've ever seen for internet radio. And the fact is, radio is going to die. I don't listen to regular radio anymore. It sucks. I do listen to satellite radio, but once Howard Stern retires, that shit is going to fall by the wayside because that's totally content-driven, and you got to have some hardcore fucking people on there to get subscribers and get someone to pay money, pay $15 a month to listen to the fucking what you got. I like satellite radio, but the fact is, without internet radio and satellite radio, radio is going to die. So it's all about content, and that's what we're all about. And we want to thank Gas House Radio for allowing us to broadcast to their listeners, and that's why we're celebrating Philadelphia tonight. Let's see. Let me get it set up. Are you ready, Peter? Peter, get over here.
Yeah, let's do this, dude. I'm ready.
Okay. The moment you've all been waiting for. St. Peter. And one of the things we like about Philadelphia, the young African-American boy who grew up in the ghetto of West Philadelphia. He was born and raised on the playground is where he spent most of his days, chilling out, maxing, relaxing all cool, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. Well, Peter, you can do it better than me. Hit that shit.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood, I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking our juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel Air living like? This might be alright. But wait, I hear the Princey Bourgeois and all that. Is this the type of place that they just send this cool cat? I don't think so. I see."
Cut that off. I don't know how that sounded in the chat room. All Smoky Treats is the Puff Squared owner. So glad you used Puff 2. The director should have said, "Love the TC Sabre Chamber to the size of a beach ball and hold it for 1 minute to stretch it out." I did do that. And like I said, it seems to work pretty good. There's like I said, it takes getting used to actually forcing. You know, you usually relax when you exhale, but you really can't relax. You got to kind of give it a little oomph to get it into the balloon. But then it's like it's in a balloon, man. You can use it again. So that's cool. So shout out to Smoky Treats in the chat room. Everybody's loving the Fresh Prince song. Peter, that was a fucking home run, man. Usually, you really don't pull your weight around here, and you really are a detriment to the show in most instances, but that was pretty cool.
Thank you, dude. I'm going to get mad bitches for this.
Yes, mad bitches will be blown up your Twitter, at @ST_Peter420. Let's see if we got anybody on the phone. Nobody on the fucking phone. So I'm tweeting out the phone number, goddammit, 760-454-1109. Now you bitches are going to call and talk? You know what will be made famous worldwide on the Philadelphia show? What else we got going on? Okay, well, that's it for this instance of what we like about Philadelphia. There's a hurricane coming. The East Coast, Philadelphia's in line. So, you know, watch that shit. We don't have to worry about hurricanes or really earthquakes in this neck of the woods. We do get tornadoes. They'll blow through here every once in a while. Coming up, we have more things. We're going to do one of the things we don't like about Philadelphia, including flash mobs and what they're doing in Philadelphia. You're just a bunch of stupid little fuckers. Let me tell you what, man. We'll get into it, but if you want to debate me about gun rights, this is one of the things. One person getting attacked by a flash mob, being armed with a gun, would change the entire scenario. Bust a cap in a couple of those little fuckers, and you watch the rest of them run like little roaches. That's right. You heard me. You heard me. In the theme of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, we're going back 20 years for our slang terminology. Bust a cap. You bust a cap and like one of the ringleaders or whatever, watch the rest of them run. Anyway, we'll talk about flash mobs coming up. Also, what else we got? More things we like about Philly, including the greatest, one of the greatest TV shows, if not the greatest TV show, I don't know, it's arguable, in television history, It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. It's based in Philadelphia. We love that shit. We'll talk about that and see if we can find a clip on YouTube to play for that shit. See, this is what I get when I get diarrhea of the mouth. My voice starts to go, and we still got 1:16 left in this fucking show. We're also going to do the prank calls of the radio stations and the Danny Bonaducci shit. Let's go check the chat room for some feedback. Smokey Treats said summertime was better for Will Smith. Man, Will Smith, he's just fucking everywhere. And now his kids are everywhere. Although that Whip Your Hair Back and Forth song, oh, man. I've never wanted to smack a little girl more than when I hear that song. I want to say, shut up, you dumb little bitch. I'm sorry I'm calling a kid a bitch, but she's a dumb little bitch. Stop it. Stop whipping your hair back and forth, and more importantly, stop telling me about it, because I don't give a fuck. Let's see. MTPG said, I've never seen a flash mob in person. Frankly, to be perfectly honest with you, I think a bunch of people getting together and dancing. I mean, I guess it was for a purpose. There's like political flash mobs. But if you just get together in a public place to dance like a fucking retard to a stupid song, I'm sorry, I don't get it. I don't get that, and I don't get planking. I'm sorry. Lord, we just said, love thy neighbor, bust mad caps, and flash mob ass. Yes. That's what I'm saying, man. Like I said, we'll talk about it coming up. This is the Stoner Jesus Show live. We're going to play some music. I'm going to play some commercials for our awesome sponsors, which if you don't know and you're just joining us, are THCFinder.com and WestCoastMasters.com. You'll hear the commercials, but go to WestCoastMasters.com and THCFinder.com and check that shit out. Right now we're going to play Mr. Infamy, one of the earliest sponsors of my video site. You can find a link to that on StonerJesus.net. Mr. Infamy, he's at Mr. Infamy on Twitter and InfamyTV.com. This song is Ready to Rock. We are broadcasting live from the Stoner Jesus Studios in the Mid-Ohio River Valley, simulcast id on the Philadelphia-based internet radio station, GasHouseRadio.com. We'll be back after this.
It was all a dream, staring at the TV screen, watching really see like that could be me.
Ready to rock.
Oh, when I'm the beeper, I'ma take it deeper, let you be my equal opposed.
Yeah.
And it was all a dream, staring at the TV screen, watching really see like that could be me.
Ready to rock.
Oh, when I'm the beeper, I'ma take it deeper, let you be my equal opposed.
I can't see
it. And you never will, cause you ain't on my level. Yeah, I'm a son of a bitch, and my father's the devil, in case you ain't heard. I was born for this, you never do an 84, I've been in Jersey, great, be this, from the gate, I've been rapping this tape, speaking rhymes on my way to school, trying to escape my reality, and I follow me, the bitches getting deeper, I've been wanting this, since I heard my Adidas, they know about 16, so where they go, I just knew how to rhyme, and you feel the flow, push up, I see my vision, never kept nothing written, everything was up and top of the dome. It was all a dream, staring at the TV screen, watching ring and feel like that could be me.
Ready to rock.
Oh, when I'm the beeper, I'ma take it deeper, let you be my equal opposed. And it was all a dream, staring at the TV screen, watching ring and feel like that could be me.
Ready to rock.
Oh, when I'm the beeper, I'ma take it deeper, let you be my equal opposed. And you never ever will until you walk in your field. Do that shit, you can feel like it myself, like shit. For real, I ain't playing, check the words, I be praying. Magic 48 bars, I'm so
dig it deeper. Let you be my heap of a pose. And it was all a dream, staring at the TV screen. Watching brand new scene like that could be me. Oh, bring up the reaper. I'ma dig it deeper. Let you be my heap of a pose.
I can't see ya.
Are you a medical marijuana patient, but you're new to it and you don't know about the dispensaries that are near you or about different strains and things like that? Well, the perfect place to go is THCfinder.com, your true bud finder. You can not only find the nearest dispensary to you, you can see reviews about that dispensary from other patients, just like yourself. You can go in the forum and talk to other patients either about growing or strains or whatever you want to talk about. Plus, there's news and all kinds of other cool stuff at THCfinder.com. You can follow them on Twitter at THCfinder. They are a proud sponsor of the Stoner Jesus Show. We'll be back right after this. Stoner Jesus, and you're listening to Gas House Radio, the pride of Philadelphia, if you don't count the Flyers, the Phillies, the Eagles, Rocky, and the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down, and I'd like to take the manager.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Stoner Jesus Show live, the Philadelphia edition, celebrating our debut, our live debut on GasHouseRadio.com. Getting back into the show, the last show we're going to talk about, we're going to talk right now about things that we don't like about Philadelphia. Let me go check the chat room. Let's see. Pineapple 17 is in the chat room, but seems to be having problems hearing the show. I don't think anybody else is having trouble, so I don't know. I don't know why. But we got all kinds of people in the chat room. Bongmaster, Canvas Clay, Dustin, the owner and operator of GuestHouseRadio.com, Lord Wiedis, MedV, who I think said they were from Slovakia. You never know, but that's very cool. We've had downloads for this show on iTunes from as far away as like New Zealand and Australia and Denmark and Sweden. We get callers. We've had callers from Nova Scotia and Canada and Great Britain. We get a lot of downloads and listeners from. It's fucking awesome. Things we do not like about Philadelphia. And let me go check. Let's see. Oh, yeah, before we get out of the Rocky mode, Canvas Clay said, is posting up things from a message board. I'm not sure what message board this is from, but John O'Leary of Harrisburg says, wants to know, Rocky 3 had Mr. T, but Rocky 4 had Drago. Which Rocky was the most badass? Of course, Rocky 4 was older than Rocky 3, so Rocky 3 could probably kick Rocky 4's ass. But I would have to give, I don't know who's more badass between the Russian, Dolph Lundgren, and Mr. T. If you're in the chat room, just you go ahead and make a quick little vote in the chat room. Who was more badass, Mr. T or Drago? Rocky 3 or Rocky 4? let's see. Let's go back and check if Pineapple's had any luck getting back into the chat room or hearing the show at least, and I do not see an update. There are a bunch of other people in the chat room. That's awesome. If you want to call the show, 760-454-11. 09. What's up, Peter? Will we you into this right now, man?
Let's go to shit.
Damn right. We're halfway through the show. We're going to be pranking prank calls here in a little while. We want to get through this list of things we do not like and more things that we do like about Philadelphia. As I mentioned, flash mobs is one of the things we don't like about Philadelphia. There seems to be a little tendency among the youth of Philadelphia to gather in places coordinated through social networking, that kind of shit, to either, like, rob and pillage or beat the shit out of people or things of that nature. And, you know what? Fuck those people. The flash mob bitches. If you need a bunch of other people to do your shit, then you're a pussy. Okay? Well, getting a little personal stuff, Senator Jesus was on the end of some ass whippings by multiple people. Group of 8 at one point and a group of 20 plus at another point. Those are true stories. So I know what it's like. These people are bitches. They're not going to come at you one-on-one. And I tell you what, if one of these motherfuckers had a gun, you see these people, or one of these kids, they run up and they're, they're yelling, oh, you know, we're a flash mob, bitch. Philly represent, or whatever they say when they're flash mobbing people. And one of them comes up and punches you in the head. And you're like, oh man, it's fucking flash mob time. You whip out your piece and just fucking pop one of them. That shit is over. It is over. I don't care if there's 30 of them. If you shoot one of them, the other 29 are going to run like motherfuckers. And flash mobs are over. It's over. In Philadelphia, there will be no more flash mobs if one of them gets shot. It just won't happen. Because they're going on their little Twitters and their Facebooks like, man, sure bet that motherfucker got shot. That's crazy. I don't want to get shot. Let's find something else to do. Let's go home and smoke a bowl and eat some Cheetos and watch Adventure Time. Let's not go out and beat the shit out of people for no fucking reason. You stupid little pussies. I hate that. I fucking hate that. As I said, probably I'm a little colored by my past experience, but if you're going to be such a fucking pussy that you need, like, 10 other people with you, fuck you. I hope you get hit by a bus. I hope you and your family are going to a family reunion. Let me stop. Let me stop and take a little page out of Howard Stern's book. Dear God, dear Stoner God, I pray that anyone who's ever been in a flash mob and beat down an innocent fucking person, they get on a bus with their family and everyone they love, and they're taking a bus to Arizona for a family reunion. Their entire fucking family, everyone they've ever loved, is on this bus, And on the way to the family reunion in Arizona, they take a wrong turn and plunge into the fucking Grand Canyon. And they all die in a big flaming ball of fucking flame. And Stoner Jesus' name, and the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Just do that. Just do that for me. You stupid little pussies. Speaking of pussies, I want to get into the other thing we don't like about Philadelphia. I can only figure out two things I don't like about Philadelphia. One of them, of course, was the Fresh Mob. First, I told the chat room to talk about the difference between Mr. T and Drago, and then I didn't tell everybody listening and listening on the podcast later what they said. Medev, or Medvi, from Slovakia, said Drago is badass, Mr. T is dunchbag. I guess dunchbag is a hardcore slam in Slovakia. Yo, what up, you dunchbag? Is that a Slovakian accent? I don't know. I thought it was pretty fucking good. What's your Slovakian accent, Peter?
You fucking dunchbag. You fucking dunchbag.
That was brilliant. There's very few impressions that St. Peter can do. One of them is Darth Vader. Hit it, Peter.
Like a face, disappointment.
That's fucking brilliant, man. You're Rich Little, reincarnated. If you don't know who Rich Little is, first of all, well, go Google it. So Google's for to look up who Rich Little is. Now, there might be some people might, because he was in a, or at least someone playing him was in a episode of Family Guy, so they may know. Roach Never said Mr. T. Lord Weedus said Drago. Candace Clay said Drago made me pee. I was afraid of commies, too. Yeah, he did have the, Drago had the extra oomph behind him of being part of the communist dictatorship. Those motherfuckers will fuck you up. The KGB is still killing people. Don't kid yourself. Roach Never said they are both decent actors, not. Lord Weedus said, I must crush you or pity the fool. Come on. Candace Clay is baked. And I guess the, let's see. Shouldn't you say dad, SJ? No, I call him Senator God. I have to be very, very formal about about who, how I address him. Dustin said they beat the shit out of random people walking down the street. I'm assuming he said shit. It's censored, as chat rooms are wont to do. The Blog Talk Radio chat room does the same fucking thing. But it's true. I mean, there's a fucking video of it online of these dumb motherfuckers getting together and just saying, oh, we're going to beat the shit out of this person and beating the shit out of them. I don't know. What the fuck? Anyway, the next thing we don't like about Philadelphia is Mike Vick. And I got to tell you, I haven't been following the lockout and the football situation, so I'm going to assume Mike Vick is still playing for the Eagles. If he is not, Dustin or anybody else in the chat room can correct me, and then the bit will fall apart because I don't say that Mike Vick. We were doing the podcast 2 years ago, and we had these two puppies, me and Stoner Schizo and the Vampire Raven, who are parts of the show. They're not, let me see, let me go check the phone real quick. They have not called in tonight to be on the show, so that sucks. So anyway, we had these two dogs, and what we were going to do is, funny as hell, we were going to do the Mike Vick puppy fighting championships. And Dustin said he's still an Eagle. That's cool. So the bit can continue. So anyway, we were going to have the Mike Vick puppy fighting championships, because the dogs, Cheech and Chong, they're little Rottweiler German Shepherd mixes. They like to play and fight and make little noises. We were going to record that, and it was going to be the Mike Vick puppy fighting championships, and that was awesome. But anyway, so Mike Vick, and I know a lot of people get on Twitter when people start ragging on Mike Vick and say, oh, you know, he paid his debt to society, so on and so forth. But here's the problem I have. When you go after, just like the fucking flash mob people, you go after innocent, defenseless people, or in this case, animals. Animals are the ultimate in defenseless, whatever. They're animals. They're defenseless. They're innocent. They don't know anything. A dog knows what you tell it and how you react to it. And that's all a dog gives a shit about. Okay, but if you're drowning dogs or electrocuting dogs and you're making them fight for money or gambling in your fucking house, you're a pussy. You're a punk, bitch, pussy, and you don't deserve that the whole he paid his debt to society bullshit speech. Fuck that. You're torturing dogs, you stupid prick. If someone tortured children, you don't say, oh, well, he paid his debt to society. I know he dunked a child in a bucket of water and drowned it. Or he took fucking battery cables and electrocuted it to death. No. And dogs shouldn't be any different. They're just as defenseless as a child or a baby. They look to you as their owner not to be a douchebag. It's not like Mike Vick needed the money. He's an NFL player. He can run and throw a football, so he's golden. So fuck that. That's two things going on about Philadelphia. The flash mob frenzy that's going on right now, and Michael Vick. Otherwise, Philly's cool. And the most cool thing about Philadelphia, of course, guesthouseradio.com. I see people in the chat room agree with what I'm laying down. I'm dropping some knowledge into your domes. Hardcore. We have 55 minutes left in the show. We are live, simulcasting on gasthouseradio.com. This is the Stoner Jesus Show. We have a lot of shit coming up. I'll have to consult my notes, as I'm going to do right now. The schedule. We're going to be live from now on, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights. All three can be heard on Blog Talk Radio, but the Thursday night shows, they're going to be at 10 p.m. Eastern. The Thursday night shows will be heard on gasthouseradio.com, and that's the chat room we'll be in, and that's where we'll be congregating to listen to the show. While I'll be broadcasting, you'll be listening. I'm listening, too. I'm listening to the sound of my own voice. I could do this all night, but we're not going to. Coming up, we have more things we like about Philadelphia, and then we're going to get into the calls for the radio stations and the Danny Bonaducci. Coming up, what we like about Philadelphia, one of the most awesome TV shows ever. It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. Also, the new marijuana decriminalization law in Philadelphia. We like that. And, of course, we'll talk about Philly cheesesteaks. It's all coming up on the Stoner Jesus Show live on gasthouseradio.com, podcasted on stonerjesus.net. I almost got through that with no fuck-ups. It would have been very professional and awesome of me. But no, I suck. Stoner Jesus Show live. We'll be back after this. Dick Nugget.
Half-back cars running like that. Bubble gum, yum yum, coming down. green, lighting up the blunt, chilling with my hookah. Grabbing the bag in a zigzag, meeting at the back of the studio. Eyes low, we're puffing on the hydro. You don't know how the pen flows. I gotta let go, you gotta let go of the toque. So playboy drinking, smoking, I can pass it down to the homies in the session. They attest to me. You might learn a lesson, but smoking is my passion. A day-to-day action is what I do. Stop my insanity, get back and chill with my family. The ones who love me, speaking up, kissing my wife. Love my life.
Are you a marijuana grower? Are you only getting ounces per plant out of the plants you're growing? Well, man, that's because you don't have the book and you don't know the secrets of the West Coast Masters. You can get the book at westcoastmasters.com and you can follow them on Twitter at West Coast Master. You can get more than a pound per plant indoors just by learning the secrets of the West Coast Masters. And you can pick up the book at westcoastmasters.com, a proud sponsor of the Stoner Jesus Show. We'll be back after this. You're listening to the Stoner Jesus Show.
Biatch!
Because when I get high, I do. Because when you get high, people can tell you some tragic shit and it don't even matter. Somebody can walk up to you and say, Dominique, you know John got hit by a truck. Shit be happening. He need to watch where he going. I walk around high all the time. I don't get hit by shit. You know, I got fired from my job, too. My supervisor came to me. She said, Dominique, you know tomorrow your drug test. I just laughed. She said, why you laughing? I said, because this must be my last day. Because I'm positive as hell. I pee in that cup, knees and smoke and all types of shit come out that cup. So since y'all play, hey, not quit. I ain't never been good at working no job, though, because I ain't follow the rules. Because just because you say be there at 8 o'clock, that don't mean nothing to me. You the supervisor, won't you go at 8 o'clock? You make the most money, but I get up the earliest. That don't go together. You go in and set up for me, and I get there when I get there. You understand what I'm saying? And when I did work, I did what I got paid to do. If I got paid to Xerox, that's all I did was Xerox. You better call somebody to get this paper because it's piling up. And that shit look real unprofessional lined all on the wall. Now, we can renegotiate a dollar or two and I carry it upstairs for it. But other than that, give me a chair. I'm getting dizzy looking at this machine go back and forth. And if I hit my head, I'm going to sue your ass. Then I'm going to be the supervisor.
Days, a Canada band, blazing bright and early. Before that, you heard a stand-up comedian named Dominique. You even heard a little bit about weed. I found out on YouTube. That's awesome. Speaking of YouTube, I didn't go to YouTube to find It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. First, though, we'll talk about one of the things we like about Philadelphia. This is Saturday Edition Show Live, by the way. We are broadcasting on GasHouseRadio.com. I lost the song. Where's the song so I can end it? There it is. Very professional. As always, we're broadcasting live from the Stoner Jesus Studios in the Mid-Ohio River Valley, U.S. of A. I'm with my sidekick, St. Peter. What up, St. Pete?
What up, Home Skillet?
Don't call me Home Skillet. You know how I hate that. The city of Philadelphia. This story comes from the 420times.com. Back in July, the city of Philadelphia, adopted a new marijuana enforcement policy that took effect in June 2010. Under the new policy, police issue a summons to those caught with under 30 grams of marijuana instead of arresting and criminally prosecuting them. According to City District Attorney Seth Williams, Philadelphia has seen a savings of roughly $2 million since the program took effect last year. Over the past year, Philadelphia would have prosecuted over 4,000 people for having marijuana, but they avoided that, and that's cool, and that's another thing we like about Philadelphia. One of the things I'm not liking right now is there's nobody on the fucking phone that wants to talk. Fuck you bitches. But we can call out, so we'll have fun anyway. Let's see. Cannabis Clay sending me shit from the message board, and also other shit in direct message on Twitter. From the message board, let's see. Message board, Lori Giannotti asked, do you remember Mitch Wild Things Williams? Could he have won the World Series if he smoked weed? I don't know. I mean, all I remember really about Mitch Williams is he made one bad pitch in the World Series, and Joe Carter took him yard. And that's always been remembered for. Most people don't even recognize his nickname, Wild Thing. But he was the dude who gave up the Joe Williams home run that won the Blue Jays the World Series and sent the Phillies home. Also from the message board, Lou Ayers wants to know, you can't say a bad thing about Randall Cunningham, though, can you? P.S. Michael Vick is a dick nugget. If you don't know what Dick Nugget is, it's sweeping the nation. You can get the official Dick Nugget t-shirt at StonerJesus.net. Randall Cunningham. No, Randall Cunningham, he wasn't much of a passer, but he was one of the first, if not the first, really mobile quarterbacks. I believe he was the first quarterback to rush for 1,000 yards. Well, I'm not sure about that either. Canvas Clay also said Mannequin and Mannequin 2 on the Move were both set in Philly, starring Andrew McCarthy, Kim Cattrall, Meshach Taylor, and James Spader. I vaguely remember Mannequin. I remember the movie Sucking Hard, and Mannequin 2 had to suck even harder, I'm sure. So, anyway, Canvas Clay did give us some phone numbers about the Danny Bonaduce thing. We'll be getting that to the minute in a minute, and we're going to call other radio stations in Philly and tell them the shit is on. This shit right here that I'm talking about, it's on. let's see. Roach never said, what's the number he hangs at McFadden's. I don't know. Who was I talking about? See, there's a delay here, and I also have some short-term memory loss at the moment. So I'm not sure. I'm not sure who you're talking about. Maybe Randall Cunningham? Randall Cunningham's cool. Like I said, he wasn't much of a passer. Motherfucker could run now. You weren't going to catch him. You're not going to catch Michael Vick either. Well, I mean, yes, they did. I guess if he stops to drown a dog in a bucket, then you can get your hands on him. Let's see. MTPG said, I can't send a number over this. Any number you want to send me, DM me at StonerJesus420, and I will check that shit out. I was going to play something. See, the thing about It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, which is a show I love. It's another thing we love about Philadelphia. Maybe one of the best shows ever. But see, they don't allow a lot of clips from the show on here. If you haven't seen, here's Kitten Mittens. That's one of the best episodes of It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. This fucking cat with mittens on it, trying to get them off. see, all they have is like promos and shit for It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. They don't have like funny clips or whatever. But anyway, It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia is an awesome, awesome show. It's another thing we love about Philadelphia. And last but not least of the things we love about Philadelphia is Philly cheesesteaks. I'm a person who loves meat, and I love cheese. You put that shit together. Now, I don't live in the Philadelphia area, as you know. I'm in northern Kentucky, if you want to get specific about what's going on here. So the closest thing we have is, if you've ever heard of Penn Station, is a sub place, East Coast Subs, whatever. That's the closest you can get in this area to a Philly cheesesteak. And I'm sure it's nowhere near as good as what you can get in Philadelphia. But it's pretty fucking good, which makes me imagine that an actual Philadelphia cheesesteak from Philly would be fucking awesome. Let's see. Mitch. Oh, Mitch Williams hangs at McFadden's, or McFadden's. I'm sure that's probably supposed to say. I didn't even remember him until it was brought up by Cannabis Clay from a message board through direct message on Twitter. Michael Vick. And Mitch Wildthing should have like a podcast or something together. Michael Vick can talk about dog care and grooming, and Mitch can talk about choking in Game 7 of the World Series, or Game 6, or whatever it was. Bongmaster said, SJ, what's the best kush you've ever smoked? I don't know. I really couldn't put one above the other. I smoked regular, Cali kush that we've got through here. Not a lot of good shit comes through here. But when it does, it's pretty special. Purple Kush and one other type of Kush is escaping me now. But they're all fucking good. If you can get a hold of a Kush, you're good to go. In the chat room, Harry Butt has joined in the chat room, along with a bunch of other people, Ballmaster, Canvas Clay, Dustin, Lord Weedus, MTPG, Pineapple, Smoky Treats, who is the Puff 2, Puff Squared guy, Puff Squared on Twitter. Now, we've gotten through all that. It's time for the shit you all have been waiting for and the shit you love. Let me go mark down everything in the show here on the show notes so I don't redo anything. Because Peter is sure not fucking going to help me.
Yeah, probably not, dude.
Fucking dick. We're going to make some phone calls. And we're going to start with... I have to go get the phone numbers that Cannabis Clay sent me for... The Danny Bonaducci show. He's Danny WYSP at gmail.com. Okay, WYSP. If I'm not mistaken, that was Howard Stern's affiliate in Philadelphia. I'm not 100% sure. You may want to fact check me on that, whoever's on there. The request line, Mechanics Clay sent this to me at 942. There was a guy named Gordon on there. They have a business number. The business number is probably a 9-to-5 thing. I don't know if the request number... is going to get me a real person, but it may at the very least get me a voicemail or something of that nature. So I assume, erased one of the numbers. I'm going to go back and check that. let's see. It's a 215 number. Okay. So far, so good. Dustin said that's correct. That Howard Stern was on YSP. If you have satellite radio and you listen to some of the old Howard Stern shit, that shit is awesome. I call him to aspire to be that type of broadcaster and to have awesome shit going on. But, Pineapple said, fixing your computer when you're stoned is probably the hardest thing you ever do, but I did it. Fucking A, Pineapple. Welcome. You're just in time for the live prank phone calls. Yeah. And it's shit like this, hopefully, that will provide the content that people want to hear. Taylor sent me a bunch of phone numbers for the prank phone calling That's awesome. Right now, let me get back to this. We're going to try to call, I believe it's the request line, for WYSP in Philadelphia, Stoner Jesus Live, guesthouseradio.com. Please, someone will answer. We discuss Danny Bonaducci. Come on. Come on, man. I'll rehearse a song. call failed. It was not answered. What kind of bullshit is that? WYSP don't want to know what I want to talk about? I mean, fuck that. Hold on. I got to get my list of Philly radio stations again so we can call some people. I'll do it live on the air. This is the people's and the listeners' favorite part of the show when I type on the air. It is awesomeness. Let's see. WISP is Rock, the rock station of Philadelphia, according to this little list. Who else we got? Country, Philadelphia's country station. Let's call them. We're going to have to go to their website, I imagine, and find a phone number. So I can call. Wow. See, this is 92.5 XTU, Philadelphia's country station. Right now, Ken Anderson is on. All I'm needing, homie, here we go, contact us. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Business phone, request line. That's what I'm talking about. The CSS station hours. But wouldn't they take requests after hours? Isn't that what a DJ does? Isn't that your fucking job, DJ? Anyway, let's bust this number in and see if we can talk to a country station in Philadelphia and let them know that the radio war is on, bitch. We're in Philadelphia. We're not going anywhere. And we're going to tell people. We're going to alert them. Wow, call failed or was not answered already. Well, shit, man. This is bombing. This is bombing worse than a Muslim in Israel. I don't know, it was kind of a clunky metaphor, but you get my point. So far, Dustin said they probably don't have DJs, they're probably all computerized. Man, fuck that. What the fuck, man? That's what's wrong with radio, right there. That's why radio's dying. Computerized? Come on, man. We're live in the air, bitches. Let's do this. I want to get away from that. What about college stations? Well, I want there to be somebody at a college station, some little fucking intern trying to get some credits. Come on. What about Drexel University? WKDU 91.7. Late Night Dudes is on right now from 9 to 12. And they got a phone number. So let's see if we can call the Late Night Dudes on WKDU in Philly. And tell them. I just want to tell someone that it's on. How hard is that? I just want to tell someone that is on and that the radio war has started. Fuck, Peter, can we do this?
No, let's do this, man. Let's tell the motherfuckers that the radio war is on.
That's what I just said. Don't repeat me. We're going to tell them that the radio war is on. Okay, WKDU Philadelphia 91.7, Late Night Dudes. Let's see if they'll answer. College Radio, Drexel University. Hardcore. Kind of late night dudes are not live late night dudes. They're just late night dudes. Okay, I'm going to try one more, and then we're going to abandon this whole fucking radio war idea for something else. Ridley High School Radio, I don't guess there ain't going to be there. There ain't going to be anybody there at 94.9. That sucks. Power 99, the People Station. Hip hop. Come on, man. It's Thursday night. Can't there be somebody at the hip-hop station to take my call? We're going to see. I can listen live. I don't want to listen live. I want to contact. No contact. Let's see. information? No? No contact information. How fucked up is that? Why don't you want to be contacted, Power 99? You got something to hide? Are you hiding from the Stoner Jesus show? Because somebody told you it was on, like Donkey Kong? Yeah. Yeah. You didn't know, did you? Now you know. Now you heard. Fuck, man. There's no contact information on this page. What kind of bullshit is that, man? I can't contact you? Info. Station info. Let me go to that. There's got to be a number, man. I want to request a hip-hop song. Shit. Studio hotline. Philly, local area. This is it, man. This better go well, or I'm abandoning the radio station prank calls, and we'll go back to other shit. So we're going to try this. What is this? This is Power 99 hip-hop in Philly. Stoner Jesus Show Live. Call failed or was not answered. You mother chuckers. I'm abandoning the Power 99 and all the radio shit. Cannabis Clay says I have a text for Power 99. Oh, man, fuck them. Dustin said try 93.3 WMMR. Let's do that. We will, let's see, where's my thing? Where's the little thing I just had? My tab. There we go. Where are we at? WMMR, home of rock and roll. Let's see what kind of number they have. Let's see if I can get a hold of them. Shit, man. That's why you suck, regular radio. Because you're not there, and I'm here. So people are listening to me and saying, fuck you. Okay, what do we got here? About? Go to the About page. Contact. Booyah. Get a number. They put in a little requesting contest line, fax, business office, love you, hate you line. We may do the little fucking love you, hate you line if shit gets out of hand here. Let's see, there's the number. See, they spell. I don't think I can spell with my, I don't have like a little dial-out thing, so I don't know what shit spells. Real quick in the Gas House chat room, WMMR, what are the numbers for that? I need the numbers for WMMR. What are the numbers on the dial pad? Because I do not have a dial pad handy, and I'm not going to go fucking look for one. But that's the awesome thing about having people in a chat room who are listening to your show. Let's see. What's going on in the chat room? The usual suspects. Rasta is, yes, listening on the phone. Although she's not on the phone right now listening, as far as my little shit. Anybody in the chat room, WMMR, what are the letters or the numbers for that? And I'll call WMMR. And then we'll take a break. We've got about 25 minutes left in the show. Dustin, coming through, 9667. That's what I'm talking about. We're going to call WMMR. We're going to try to tell someone that the radio war is on in Philadelphia. But nobody wants to listen. I want to tell them. I'm not hearing ringing. Come on, homie. I'm not hearing fucking ringing. Let's do this. But nothing? Not hearing nothing. It just says dialing. Oh, man. It just says dialing. Now call was failed or not answered. Maybe I got to put a 1 in front of it. We'll try that. We'll dial it again. Well, I think with this system, it really doesn't matter, but... Oh, maybe it does. Maybe it's my math problem the whole time. Call failed or was not answered. Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch on a motherfucking cracker. That's bullshit. During the break, I'm going to find some other cool shit in Philadelphia for us to call. I'll also try, let's see, MTPG sent me some numbers. Canvas Clay sent me some numbers, all the numbers for WMMR. MTPG sent me some numbers. I hope one of these numbers isn't you, like it was last week, MTPG. And maybe we'll look up some other things. We only have 23 minutes left in the show. We got to get the shit going. We got to call some motherfuckers and get it on and popping, as they say in the ghetto. Speaking of the ghetto, this is the Hoodfellas. You can find them on Twitter, Mr. Infamy and another rapper make up the Hoodfellas. This is a song called Hood. This is the Stoner Jesus Show live on GasHouseRadio.com. We'll be back.
What it do? The Hoodfellas.
You already know.
OKA on the beat. I'm Mr. Infamy.
You know, and stay hood from my head to my shoes. Always on my jersey shit, but I ain't one of you fools. I cruise on the low, yeah, I'm driving tight slow. Just to let you all know, I'm in the building for show. This shit ain't for show, but it'll blow your mind. So put your man back in line before we put him in pine. Front line, cause I'm a stunner, pull up in a Hummer. Gas tank go E, but I pulled your baby mama. Knuckle game serious, so why even bother to get your ass whooped in front of your mother and father? I lay hands on your life, prayer hands on your catch your ass at the liquor store, get your ass a Royal Rumble. Jumble through the project, stuck in the hood, rats in the cut, with the block boys burning the weed sack. You see that? Yeah, I got you open. Your boy's so hood, but I'm still so focused.
Got a mean ass, have to turn on the weekend, every Chevy doing a dash. Well, making asses, now I'm making cash. My boys turn into men like Vince, Furious and Fast. Mama and that young man do they thing in that kitchen. Sip that young man whipping just a little bit different. We your fool niggas eat ya, mama might beat ya. Bitches fall to the streets and lose their best features. Party every weekend, niggas in and out of jail. We be treated like heaven, though we living in hell. Knocking, sending in a rockin', niggas catching assists with the mailman like Stockton. With no hope, water gutter to bottom. But we don't give a fuck about a bill like Rodham. Fly boys, the hood rats are 9 to 5. If you come from the bottom, you're the source of power. For the source of weed, buys a liquor, man. Hey, niggas, drink, see if you can. A crack, a car, wide, dope, and panic. We the got bullets, they sing on the planet. Duck, even though you block, I take your bitch. Got movies where they come out, jump off the dime a dozen. And I ain't quite banging, but they still call me cousin. What we call a homie, love when I leave, but don't. That's the hood, and I'm here to dead and go.
Watch it, don't, cause it might get busted. The cops in the thick of kids are not to be fucked with. Trust and believe, gotta watch them fiends, cause they will fuck you over if you're not hit to the skin. Your dreams will be shattered by flashy lights. That's why every little homie out here hustling white, it ain't right, but it's all they know and all they got. So who the fuck are you to ever hate on the block?
Blood boys, the hood rats are 9 to 5. And if you come from the bottom, you're the source of power. For the stores of weed, buys a liquor, man. Hey, niggas, drink, see if you can. A crack, a car, why don't you can? If we done got bullets, they sing on the planet. Traffic get ready, get buzzed, shit get stuck. Everybody fed up. Blood boys, the hood rats are 9 to 5. And if you come from the bottom, you're the source of power.
Jesus H. Christ. You You're listening to the Stoner Jesus Show live. Check out all the podcasts on stonerjesus.net.
Like I said, I come in the name of Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Left in the show, according to my little clock. So we're going to get into it. We got to do some prank calls in Philadelphia. I got to get a hold of somebody in fucking Philadelphia and prank call their ass. We're going to do an oldie but a goodie, and I have some Philadelphia pizzerias that I've looked up. Pizza places, they have to fucking answer. It's their livelihood. So this is Petro's Pizza, Cold Oven Pizzeria on Walnut Street in Philadelphia. If any of our Philadelphia listeners know that place, that's who we're going to call. Petro's Pizzeria. I remember this time to put a 1 in front of it. Or I will remember as soon as I get the call in here or the number in. We put it in the little magical prank calling machine. Like I said, we're going to give them an oldie but a goodie, something classic. I just want to prank somebody in Philadelphia, man. That's the whole fucking point of the prank calling portion of the Philadelphia show. Stoner Jesus Show Live. Let's check this out. Petro's Pizzeria. Call failed. Or was not, it's a fucking pizza place, man. How can they not answer the phone? Oh, my God. I don't know, man. I don't fucking know. We're going to go with the original Taco Nelly's Pizzeria on East Somerset Street in Philadelphia. I have no fucking idea where any of these places are. But I do know the Petros, they don't want my pizza order. Maybe they see the out of... the 760 area code, where the fuck I'm calling from. And they're like, oh, man, they can't be ordering pizza from here. It's the 760 area code. Maybe we can find someone who's not paying attention to answer the fucking phone. Stoner Jesus Show.
Hi, this is Tacanelli's. I'm sorry, we are sold out for today, Thursday. If you are calling regarding an order that you've already placed for Thursday, please leave a message. If you would like to place an order for Friday or Saturday, please call back Friday after 10 a.m. The best time
advanced.
To come in on...
O-M-G, as the kids say. This is fucked up, man. Dustin says it's 11:45. Shops close up early in Philly. Yeah, I guess so. They don't get fucking flash mobbed. Oh, man. I don't know. Come on. This is the last shot. If this don't work, I'm calling it. I'm calling it fucking dead. I'm going to call a cab company. If they don't answer, then I don't know. If a cab company won't answer, I don't know what the fuck to do. What do we got here? We got PHL Taxi, Liberty Cab, All City, ACS, City Cab, Capital Dispatch. We're going to go with Liberty Cab Company. I want to get in one good Philadelphia prank call before we wrap this shit up. Is that so hard? I mean, there's been some hit and miss prank calls on this fucking show before, but tonight has been especially brutal. So we'll put in this number, and if the cab company won't pick up, then it's official. Philadelphia is closed for the night, and they will reopen promptly at 9 a.m. in the morning. Standard Jesus Show Live. Come on, bitches.
Thank you for calling Liberty Cab. An operator will be with you shortly. Again, thank you for calling.
Wow, seriously, I'm on hold?
Liberty Taxi, can I help you?
Yeah, man, I'm calling about the ad you had there on Craigslist. Is the item still available?
What item is that?
It's the 14-inch, slightly used marital aid. I was really hoping if you haven't sold that yet, I'll give the asking price of the $45 if you still have it.
Hold on a second.
Am I being transferred to the dildo section? I think you just put me on hold. Come on, man. Transfer me to the slightly used marital aid section so we can get this this sale transaction underway. 14 inches, man. Peter likes that. Ain't that right, Peter?
Fuck you, dude.
Fuck you too, asshole. Okay, I think dude put me on hold. Not a very good sense of humor. Not at all. We'll try All City Taxi. We'll see what they got to say. The 14-inch marital aid thing is works out very well. If people will get into the spirit of what we're doing here. S4 numbers of this cab company are all sixes. That's kind of bizarre, but yeah. This Judeo-Christian society. I don't know. I don't know if we want to call them with the marital aid. Yeah, we'll do the marital aid again, because that guy didn't really bite, man. He didn't make a very good call. This is the last call, though, for Philadelphia.
All City, give me your phone number, please.
Yo, what up? I'm seeing if you still got that thing I saw on Craigslist, man. You're selling. You still got that? Holmes! Hung up on me! Bitch! Mm. 10 minutes left in the show. Cannabis Clay says, check your DM, Stoner. I will do that. I will go check my direct messages on Twitter. Hopefully it's something good. B101 WBEB Studio Contest Phone for Philadelphia. I'm going to forego that because I've learned from experience tonight that Philadelphia is closed for the evening, and they will reopen in the morning. We're going to try one of MTPG's numbers to see if we can get a good prank call before we wrap this shit up. Hopefully this is not MTPG's own phone number, as he did last week. Hopefully it's an actual phone number. Let me go, for the life of me, I can't remember my prank calls. I gotta go check I gotta consult my notes, my prank calls, and see which one you want to use for the last one. This is the last call tonight. This is not a Philadelphia call, but as I said, Philadelphia's closed, so we cannot go for that. I could do the old man with Alzheimer's. No. I'm gonna go with a telemarketer call. We'll try that. See if, MTPG gave us a good number for telemarketer call. Stoner Jesus Live. Yes, that's radio.
Hello?
Hello. I'm an asshole telemarketer, and I was hoping I could take up some of your valuable time with a series of nonsensical questions. Is that okay with you?
Nah, dude.
No? Oh, man, believe it or not, I've been doing this for like 8 years, and no one has ever said no, man. I got like 6 kids at home. One of them has like leukemia. I'm just trying to put some food on the table. If I can just ask you some questions, that would be really awesome.
Nah,
He hung up on me after I said my kid has leukemia. How fucking hardcore is that? Ah, you're hardcore, dude. That's what I'm saying. That was a number MTPG sent me. That dude is hardcore. Okay, let me try another MTPG phone number. Let's see if they want to talk to the telemarketer. Damn. My kid, man. I got six kids. He don't care. Does not faze him. Okay.
Hello?
Hello! I'm an asshole telemarketer, and I was hoping to take up some of your valuable time with a series of nonsensical questions. Is that okay with you, sir?
I'm doing that right now. I'm on the phone with Isla.
I'm sorry, sir. I didn't know. Was that a yes or a no? Okay, question number one. Would you buy a vibrating spoon if it was under $10? Damn it. Okay. 7.5 minutes left in the show. I'm going to pronounce the prank calling DOA for the night and call it 11:52 Eastern Time. Oh, fuck. Okay. I want to thank everybody in the chat room. I want to thank GasHouseRadio.com. Chat room, shout them out. Bongmaster, Cannabis Clay, Dustin, Harry Butt, Lord Weedus, MTPG, Pineapple 17. Quinn58 is in the chat room. Welcome, Quinn58. Road to Never, and of course the wonderful and always sexy and vivacious Stoner Jesus. We're all in the chat room tonight, plus a bunch of other people. I don't know how many other people listen tonight. Dustin will know that, and hopefully will tell me. Harry Butt just sent me a message with the phone number. Save that for Saturday night. We'll be live on Blog Talk Radio at 10 p.m. Eastern. We'll probably bust out some more prank calls because it really didn't go well tonight. I had no idea that they rolled up the sidewalks of Philadelphia at such an early time. But with the flash mob problem and the coming pending hurricane, I guess they're getting the fuck out of Dodge, as they say. This has been a production of the Stoner Jesus Show. I've been your host, and I'm still your host, Stoner Jesus, along with my sidekick, St. Peter. We've been broadcasting live in the Stoner Jesus Studios. Peter, you want to get out of here?
Yeah, man. I'm gone. Peace out, bitch.
See ya. Peter didn't put in much in work, and he gets the fuck out of here early. And that's all I'm saying. One last check of the GasHouseRadio.com chat room. Thanks, everybody, for listening. Quinn58, you came in a little late, but it's still cool. Yeah, go. The podcast will be at... They're on Blog Talk Radio, and they're at stonerjesus.net. The podcast of this show will be up at stonerjesus.net at some point tomorrow. Go to iTunes, man. Download it. Get our rankings up there. If we get the top 200, man, we will really take this shit and launch it into the stratosphere. And that's what we're trying to do. This has been the Stoner Jesus Show. I have been your host, Stoner Jesus. I already said all that. But I want to reiterate what you've been listening to. Thanks, everybody, for listening. This has been live. It's been cool. Like I said, thanks, Dustin, Gas House Radio. Hopefully the audio was good. Good enough, at least, for everybody in the chat room. If you want to put out your opinions of the audio in the chat room, go ahead so we can get some feedback of how everything sounded, how the phone call sounded. At least nobody called in. It's weird, but, you know, they didn't. The calls out, the music, my voice, all that shit. You couldn't understand St. Peter. You're not supposed to. That's why I'm here. So, thanks, everybody. Let's get the fuck out of here and check this out. We will see you Saturday night on Blog Talk Radio. Stay tuned to Twitter at StonerJesus420. You can find out when shit's going down. The Blog Talk Radio will be back Saturday night at 10 p.m. to do all kinds of crazy shit. So, we'll see you then. Thanks, everybody. Peace out.
Oh, my God, she's so hot. Look at that. She can fit that whole bottle in her mouth.
You're listening to the Stoner Jesus Show. Oh, yeah, and I forgot to mention, stay tuned to GasHouseRadio.com 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, internet radio, GasHouseRadio.com. You can hang in the chat room and chat it up and listen to whatever come up after me, which is a good team player. I should know what's coming up after me, but I don't. I think it's music, and it's awesome. Now, we're going to go out with a cool song that Rasta sent me. I think it was Rasta who sent it to me. I don't know, but I like it because I like the California Dreamin' song, and this is a remake or a remix of the California Dreamin' song from a band called Minnesota. It's been the Standard Jesus Show live. See you Saturday night. Follow Stoner Jesus at twitter.com/StonerJesus420 and twitter.com/StonerJesusNet. You can follow St. Peter at twitter.com/ST_Peter420. The Vampire Raven is at twitter.com/TheVampireRaven and Stoner Schizo is at twitter.com/StonerSchizo. Schizo is spelled S-K-I-T-Z-O. And Cannabis Clay can be found on Twitter at twitter.com/CannabisClay and at cannabisclay.wordpress.com.